And it's one thing to make something that flies. Everything flies. I mean, you can make, you know, that's the first thing I learned from Bob Wills about hang glider design. There's no trick to making something fly. There's no magic. Everything flies. A picnic table flies. You know, you just need enough power or a steep enough hill, it flies. No matter who you talk to who's participating in hang gliding, even those people who've just taken glider rides, but especially hang glider pilots, everyone would agree that it's just participating in hang gliding has been a transformative experience in their life that is something unique and special and can't be replaced by anything, not any other kind of aviation or really any other kind of sport. But still, it's the biggest issue and the biggest constraint is.
New dimensions in time and space. These are stories of the future, adventures in which you'll live in a million could-be years, on a thousand maybe worlds.
Person that the sport draws, you know, it's something that makes people want to jump off mountains.
Look at that thing.
The memories and the experiences I get from doing these flights, something that you're going to live with for the rest of your life.
Look behind us, that thing is huge.
Yeah, now I'm at that elite level, the only thing left for me is to push my own boundaries. There's one thing that I've been wanting to do for the last 6 or 7 years now, which is be the first person to fly across Australia in a hang glider.
Oh, wow.
You need something to keep pushing your limits and keep pushing you forward. achieving things that you never thought were achievable and having memories that last forever.
Here we are again for the second year. We're in Kitzbühel, Austria, for the second Red Bull speedrun competition.
Now I'm Othar Lawrence from the U.S. I've been a U.S. national champion, and I've come here to watch this really incredible hang gliding event. I paraglide a lot, and the whole goal when I go paragliding is to get as far away from the ground as possible. And these guys are spending their whole time right next to the ground, racing as fast as they can, right next to the ground, and it's amazing. And hang gliders already go maybe twice as fast as a paraglider, so for me it's really difficult to comprehend what's going through these guys' head. I mean, they just go so fast, it's really spectacular.
So for the speed run, what they have to do is take off from the ramp here, race down the hill, going through control gates on the way that are very low, so sometimes their altitude is 1 or 2 meters above the ground, and they're going at a speed of sometimes 100, 140 kilometers an hour maximum, and that's very low and very fast and very dangerous. And these guys are good, so watching it this morning has been quite impressive.
Ja, oben, das zweite Tor, da habe ich ihn so rass reingestellt, dann ist er mal voll runter, volle Tube runter. Da habe ich so viel Höhe verloren, dass ich das dritte Tor fast nicht mehr erwischt habe. Bevor ich in die Mausfallen reinratiert, habe ich so korrigieren müssen. Und dann ist es aber noch schön gegangen, dritte Tor, noch alles super, perfekt.
4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Wieder Zeit.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Very good.
John, fastest time?
Yeah, quite happy with that. Very good.
Why are you so fast?
Oh, it's a number of reasons. Got a good wing loading and just a bit of practice. I think it's all just practice. Probably done a fair, I've probably done a little bit more of this than the other people, so that helps. Lots of practice.
Okay, so match racing, that's when two pilots take off at the same time, together. And what they have to do is take off, gain altitude, go around the first buoy turn point, which is up there about half a kilometre away, gaining altitude all the time and being as quick as they possibly can. Once they're around that buoy, they come around the second turn point, which is down there on top of the lift. Once around there, they race into the goal, stacked like pancakes, and they're flying at maybe 100 kilometers an hour, just inches above the ground, and it's a really spectacular finish. It's great.
Auf alle Fälle ist es feiner, mit einem Drachen die Streif runterzuheizen, als mit Skiern, da bin ich mir ganz sicher. Man kann die Sprünge natürlich viel besser nachvollziehen, weil sie einfach weiter sind. Man kommt ja nicht am Boden auf, oder? Und ich denke mal, das ist auf alle Fälle ein größerer Kick, als mit Skiern runterzufahren.